guess I'll read this. I was kind of, I feel scattered. I worked at so many places, and my skill is really observation. I write as I see it, you know? And it's hard to kind of focus myself down into just being one thing. So I can't be one thing. This is the poem I wrote after my mother died. It's called Green is the Color. Fall is in the air, but my scarlet runners are still blooming. Their tiny red dots hang in the air while impossibly long green beans droop from the topmost leaves. I sit on an old cement block still covered with wax, last week's brass. But who cares, as I bask in the sun of an October day. Fall has arrived, and flocks of small birds whirr and flutter all around. They chirp and pull at bugs in the lawn. Behind me are hidden searching grapevine and calling, calling. Winter is coming. It's deliciously warm, and I am sad, even as I am grateful. Winter will come and wash the earth of my mother. Her sweet peas will die, and the garden will be bare, bare and brown, and all that was touched by her living hand will be gone. Her garden will be taken over by my own brother's industry and lost to winter's cold. Here in the garden, the calendulas where she grew from that she grew from scratch will die, and their seeds will fall in the dirt and wait for another day. The dahlias will have to be dug, as have the buds already. Nasturtiums will wilt on the first frost, and finally even the geraniums will turn a powdery gray, and winter will sweep the leaves into corners and gutters. Traps. Trees will bare their limbs, and then we will wait the long wait, the long bare wait, as wind makes its home in our yard, sweeping and swirling and running down the street. My mother's fine green hand will not return again on this earth. Her green days are over, and her hands will not turn the spring earth into life, or coax tiny seeds to grow in the rickety greenhouse she loved so well. She must now live in my hands. And my brothers, and then all the green things that we can grow. Those are hard.